This is the most important election of your lifetime, and the choices couldn't be clearer.
An actor rides the coattails of writers. And that's what he is. Robert's a storyteller.
He is a storyteller.
Robert is a storyteller.
That's what he was made to do.
But he has that artist's third eye that's like a beacon roaming out there in the darkness, and he sees something invisible that the rest of us don't see, and he incorporates that.
And he's very proud of his home state, very proud, and loves the university. And I, you know, this thing. And he feels that UT set him up to succeed.
Clearly that's what Robert did. He took Plan 2 for all it was worth, which is to say a great undergraduate education, and then specialized in drama, where he did very, very well.
The Plan 2 honors program really rewards the kind of student that wants to really supplement a core major with other areas of studies.
Robert's career here at UT was just, I mean, I don't know how you could have done any better. Phi Beta Kappa, Friar Society, even though he was a Plan 2 student, not a drama student, he was voted by his peers best actor.
He could sit in a panel and be with historians, with biographers, or with theater people and be equally versed in all three.
That's how he produces fictional truth through historical events, because he understands the value of getting it right.
I had heard of Robert before we started working together. I knew he was the author of The Kentucky Cycle.
So The Kentucky Cycle was just really a saga. It's telling a story of the eastern part of Kentucky in microcosm, a story of America.
It was phenomenal because that was the first time in history that a Pulitzer had been awarded to a play that was initially produced outside New York.
When All the Way came on the stage, I was absolutely mesmerized by how he depicted so faithfully the Lyndon Johnson I knew when I was at the White House.
I spent a lot of time in Austin at the LBJ Library. They're extremely helpful to me. And yet, a lot of what I gleaned in my work to develop the character for LBJ was already in Robert's play.
He really wanted to get it right. So he spent a lot of time just making sure it was accurate, not just entertaining, but accurate.
But when he gets the research, he immerses himself, he bathes himself, he showers in research, and it becomes part of it. Getting it right historically, he was free to be the artist that he is.
For All the Way, an American historical political drama, for a play like that, to be on Broadway, to win the Tony for both of them. If that doesn't say something about the incredible abilities of Robert Schenkkan, I don't know what else does.
I'm lucky. I'm nominated for a Tony, and I win. And I'm just like, wow. But the great win for me is that Robert won.
He understands how to write for the theater and how to write for film and television.
Robert painstakingly took the time to transition his play into a screenplay. He's like a surgeon with a scalpel. He carefully goes through his dialogue and scene structure, and he crafts it like an artisan that he is.
Another important part of why we're proud of Robert is that he has worked very hard to give back.
Even though not living in Austin, he comes back and lectures. He comes back and inspires students.
He's created two undergraduate scholarships. These scholarships that carry his name and his family's name and his great father's name will be bringing a person to the University of Texas for years to come.
His father, he was the founder of both radio and television and public broadcasting in Austin. You know, public broadcasting's ethos is that we are not just consumers, we are citizens. And that's clearly something that Robert Schenkkan, the son, inherited from Robert Schenkkan, the father.
I don't think it's an accident that the city of Los Angeles had a day for him. I'm really delighted that Texas is honoring him now, too.
I'm happy for my friend, Robert. He deserves it. He really does.
He's one of the great writers of the stage. He reflects honor on the institution that gave him his first chance, because he's an excellent man and an excellent artist and a damn good historian.
But he's not done. He has a terrific ambition and a drive. He was born to be a storyteller.